First of all, I would just like to say that I had to unfollow the official The Bold Type Instagram account because they always post mega spoilers, like a few days in advance. Like complete scenes or like up to a minute of a scene of the upcoming episode. Like, I don't get it. Why would you want that? I do not. I just don't understand people who like spoilers. I think part of it is the fact that I make reaction videos and so want my reaction to things to be genuine and authentic. But like, even if I didn't make them, I still don't want to be spoiled. Anyway, previously on The Bold Type, Sutton got a huge opportunity and was in charge of a shoot all on her own and kind of took a chance on Adina, and her and Kat kind of got into it over Adina, and Adina, being the mature, awesome person that she is, said to Kat, "Don't let me get between you and your friends." Jane, love her drive, love her passion. I think she maybe should have waited at least a week before trying to get a new job because, you know, it was fresh and new. Either way, she talked her way into getting a freelance job with Hot Doctor, and you know, she seems to maybe have a little bit of a crush on Hot Doctor. And Jacqueline wouldn't let her come back for her own good. No matter what, Jacqueline is just watching out for these girls. I would like to say that I'm starting to get nervous because I'm just waiting for the other shoe to drop. Like, things have gone so well that I'm scared that there's gonna be, you know, we're not gonna have an episode where something goes wrong and then, 'cause like I feel like every episode something goes wrong and then it's resolved by the end and everyone is lovely again. I'm just really afraid something's gonna go terribly wrong. Someone's not gonna be forgiving right away, and it's gonna hurt my heart. I have given my whole heart to this, and I know deep down that they won't disappoint, but that doesn't mean we're not gonna get a little pained on the way. Anyway, episode 4, here we go.
Part of my regrets, I never got to do the whole assistant thing. You know, meeting up with the other assistants, gossiping about bosses. Sounds so fun.
Oh, yeah. And the money. Brooke, meet Kat Edison, head of our social media department.
Hey.
Hi.
I'm obsessed with your Insta.
Thanks.
Go ahead.
So how long have you been at Scarlett?
About 4 years.
And already department head. Impressive.
Yeah.
Between building out the team and helping with the website relaunch, it's been kind of a
Oh, poor Sutton.
Yeah. Speaking of, I have a meeting with the editor in chief, but it was great to meet you.
The bet has been prepped, and so have you.
Oh, really getting into that assistant stuff now. Do it.
Thank you.
Kind of one of those nerds who always knew what I wanted to do, so then after college, I just.
That must be nice.
Yeah, believe it or not, I was one of those nerds, too. I'm sure you'll figure it all out.
How do you know? We just met.
Sometimes you just know. Dear God, we thank you for this food and our blessings. Amen.
Actually, let me just check our joint calendar.
Oh, God.
Please. Layla party. Who's that?
I meant to say no to that.
She's an old friend from when I was running around in New York.
I bumped into her the other day and she invited me to some party, but I don't really feel like going.
Oh, really? I mean, we can if you want to.
No, that's okay. I'm kind of tired of that scene anyway.
What scene is that?
You know, the whole New York art world lesbian scene.
I don't know, actually. It's not really my scene.
You're not missing much.
We don't want to go. I'm going to say no.
Why don't you just ask her about it?
Communication is so hard.
Yeah, but you've been doing so well at it!
Can I ask you something now?
Mm-hmm.
You talked about Kamala Angus, you can talk
world have connections. It's much easier to make it to the top when you know the right people.
You're right.
But that's why you're gonna make it, because nobody's better with people than you.
I'll be right back.
Okay.
Bye, Brooke.
Oh, bye, Sophie.
Sutton. Cool. What if I do the fitting here? Tomorrow, in the morning.
You're picking up Nacho and his worm cream. Why would you want to create extra work for yourself?
This is a good experience, and you know what they say. You can never have too many fittings.
You can, and I have. But if you're feeling so inspired, by all means.
Just don't touch it with the worm cream hands.
It's easy to be around.
Feels like there's a butt coming.
A big butt. He's religious. Like, he prayed before we ate. You don't see that around New York.
So maybe the two of us should hit the town one of these days.
Meg Rex is jealous. Yeah. Hashtag you blew it.
Here, give me your phone. I'll give you my number.
Okay.
Look at her! Uh-oh. I'm just so scared. I'm just really on edge.
I see you more as a dog walker, to be honest.
Hi. I think you're scared.
Really?
Mwah.
What I'm scared of.
You're scared that if we go out together, I'll out-report you.
Out-report?
And then you're gonna end up in bed together.
Thing. If it goes well, I'll introduce you to my editor. Happy?
Very. You said I'm not charming, but I just charmed you.
We could go to your friend's party.
I told you.
I know. It's a tired scene. But my friends are super important to me. And you've met them all. And I just think it'd be nice to meet some of the people in your life. I want to know everything about you, and your people are a part of that.
You make fair points. It's not a date. But I am seeing Ben tomorrow, which is...
Oh, boy.
Love me a good triangle. No, it is not a triangle. A triangle implies three people. Ben and I are two. The religion thing just still kind of bothers me.
But you don't even know anything about his beliefs.
It is strictly platonic.
Like, all you've ever seen is him praying. Like, talk to him about it.
Bronze bomber? Yes, cheekbone. Yeah, that's a good one. Hugo!
Oh,
my God.
I know that I can fight for
Sutton, this is Hugo, the only good thing to come from my ex.
Honestly, I'm really impressed that she introduced him to Sutton.
Oh, wow.
Like, I'm not bagging on Sutton, but like...
Wait for my opening. Most dudes don't like strange guys coming up to them at clubs and interrogating them.
Well, maybe they'd like me.
That's a nice lesbian bar.
Adina.
Marie. This is an old friend of mine, Marie. Marie, this is my girlfriend.
Yeah. You travel Turkey together?
Yeah, remember I sent you pictures.
An old friend.
Remember, I don't remember seeing any of Marie.
Can I borrow? Our friends in the corner are getting jealous. All of whom seem to know Adina's in town. I'm way too jealous for that.
What do you mean? They're mostly just friends, right?
Ah! Oh, yeah. No, of course. Just friends. Right.
Did you just send Dr. Ben straight to voicemail?
We're working, but I am seeing Ben tonight.
Text me if you change your mind.
We've been working here for the same amount of time. You're the head of a department. I'm still an assistant.
Oh, man.
I love that you're crushing it, but I want to be crushing it too.
Hey, thank you again for making us go last night.
I had fun meeting your friends. It's good. No, I actually had no idea you had so many friends. So many sexy, beautiful friends.
Why are you saying friends like that?
I mean, come on, you could feel the softball team with the amount of girls you'd slept with in that room.
I've never played softball, so
I'm serious.
Tread carefully.
What's your number? How many women?
Adina! Or Kat!
I don't ask you how many people you've been with. Is that not enough?
Yes. I mean, of course it is, but, you know. Oh, yeah. See, you know I would, but I'm gonna be late for dinner with Sutton.
I know I'm always late. And what?
Are you really trying to distract me like this right now?
Is it working?
Well.
Triangle.
Girl.
Triangle.
James, just think that religious people can be kind of judgy.
She says, judgingly.
Your cheeks are flush. You just had sex, didn't you?
God, she's like a truffle pig for hookup. Speaking of, how many people have you guys slept with?
4. 28. Makes sense. You're smooth.
Honestly, I don't even really care what her number is. I just want to be able to talk to her about it, you know, and get to know her better, and get to know her world better.
Well, have you said this to her?
That's the problem. I tried, but she just keeps avoiding the issue, you know? It makes me feel like she's hiding something.
Well, what could she be hiding?
Well, I don't know. What was Cancun Bay hiding?
How about...
I'm nervous!
Sure.
Wow. I would not have pegged you as the tattoo type.
Yeah, I got it after my residency. I like it. I can't tell if you're confused about a doctor having a tattoo or the tattoo itself.
Both. It's just, you know, you went to medical school. I guess I just wouldn't think that somebody that educated and scientific would...
Have faith.
If I were in a hospital, I would rather my life depend on good health care than prayer.
They don't have to be mutually exclusive.
Jane, we don't have to talk about this.
You're right, we don't.
You're gonna have to sometime if you want to keep being with her.
According to Facebook, Adina left me.
No!
And immediately started dating someone else.
Okay, we're still here?
Yes. I mean...
No. You're going through this all wrong!
It's not the number of...
But maybe that was her past.
No, Sutton. She was dating Coco when we met. How do I know she's not lining up someone new, like, right now?
Hi.
Hi.
What happened to
Oh, God. That made me nervous.
Don't want to talk about it. And you can invite Adina... Smooth things over.
Fine.
Or go home and talk to Adina. Shit.
Seriously, it smelled like omelets.
Next round on Scarlet?
I would maybe... Oh, don't drink too much, though.
To a really beautiful woman.
Hey, it's nothing.
You're so right, it's nothing. I'll be right back.
Oh, God.
What I need from you is your honesty. And I...
Why do they always have these conversations in bars or in clubs?
Feeling like a crazy person, which is exactly how Coco must have felt.
Oh!
I'm gonna go get a drink.
Oh.
She
needs to be careful with this Scarlet credit card.
Thanks for the drink,
Sutton. Yeah,
oh, guys. What do we think about the Bowery?
Damn.
Yeah, it's still cool.
Let's
do
it.
Oh, okay, so one of the owners, he put a few party favors on the bill.
Looks like so much easier than cash. You know?
I see.
It's fine. I do this all the time with editors. It's just never an issue.
She's not an editor.
Trust me.
Beach talk.
Okay.
I think she has too much of a conscience to be a gossip writer.
I just started getting in with Brooke. I didn't want it to jeopardize the friendship. Pat, you come back from vacation and you somehow have more responsibility. I still spend half of my day reorganizing the fashion closet.
Tell her about it. Or pay for it yourself.
I don't have the money.
Everything's going wrong.
And now I'm telling you that it feels wrong.
Look, this guy's being a jerk and we're calling him out. This is part of the job.
Well, if that's part of the job, then maybe I don't want to do it. I mean, you have to draw the line somewhere.
Ouch. Then why are you out with me and not on your date with the good doctor?
That's a good question. Thank you. You're right. He's a good guy.
I don't think
that. Sonny, I was just telling Quinn that you have to come to our next dinner party. They are legendary. Like, literally every fashion designer fights for an invite. You will seriously love it. Oh, oh, guys, the car's here. Let's go. Hey, come on.
We'll wait for you outside.
Have a dinner. God has taken your mom to a better place. And I just remember thinking, I prayed to God to keep her here with me. Because what better place is there?
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, that's kind of when I stopped believing in the magic power of God.
That's awful.
What is your stance on premarital sex?
I think we're good.
I like him too. I've liked all the guys on the show, I think.
Because I'm scared.
What are you scared of?
I'm in a relationship in a country that does not want me.
Why wouldn't you just tell me that though?
Because I don't want you to feel guilty, and I don't want to scare you off. But I'm choosing to be here, Kat. I'm choosing you.
Thank you for saying that.
Then, let me say one more thing. I love you, Kat.
I love you too.
A lot.
Yeah, no, that's good. It'll work for now, but I will get an actual number one day. Don't know how
to break the chain. Wasting time. Wow. Dina are in love. I have been waiting for this and wondering when it was gonna happen, and it finally happened. And I'm so happy that Adina was the one that said it first. I'm so happy that they can have a good communication in their relationship eventually. You know, every relationship has its ups and downs when it comes to communication. I'm also really happy and glad, and I really like the way they did that in that they just hugged and held each other after. You know, I feel like a lot of times people, like, have sex right after. But sometimes just hugging or, you know, a forehead kiss is, like, way more intimate than having sex. Next episode, I bet you that Kat is gonna be bopping around town. Sutton is making sacrifices in her life, in her inner morals, quite honestly, in order to move up in the world. I mean, you know, I feel like you can't judge either way. I'm not judging her. It sucks, you know, but yeah, I feel like in that sphere, that's kind of what you have to do, right? And I'm really glad that, I'm just really glad with all the communication that's going on in this in this show. That's been one, of my favorite things. They're pretty, like, I think it's a pretty consistent thing in this show. And, you know, Jane and Ben had that talk about religion. And, you know, she put herself out there and told them what's up. And I think that's really awesome and brave and mature. I missed Jacqueline this episode. I hope that Jacqueline gives a pep talk to Sutton about how she's trying to move up in the world, because Sutton will probably get her ass handed to her by Oliver. And in case you were wondering, yes, I was tearing up during that Kadena scene. So don't worry. This show was like a breath of fresh air. So until next week, I'm gonna try my best for hashtag no spoilers.